Hello all, my name is Ashutosh Astogi. I'm a teacher by profession. My mission is to impart quality education for all. For that purpose, I'm creating these videos. If you appreciate my work, then please do like my video and subscribe my channel so that I could get the motivation to prepare more videos. Anyways, today in this particular lecture, we will going to discuss about the error-free communication over a noisy channel, in which we will also going to discuss about the upper bound that would have been imposed by your Shannon over the channel capacity, which would have been termed as your Shannon Channel Capacity Theorem. So these are the outlines. We're going to start up with the introduction, where we will describe whatever we have discussed in our last lecture. Then we will going to discuss the error-free communication over a noisy channel, its possibility and how we can make it. Then we're going to discuss about channel capacity, which will be followed by your Shannon Channel Capacity Theorem. And finally, we're going to conclude by discussing one of the numerical problem. So in our earlier lecture, we have discussed about various types of channel, such as your deterministic channel, noiseless channel, etc., and their representation through the transition matrices. That is how we will going to represent these types of channel. So in our last lecture, we have also discussed about the channel capacity of discrete memoryless channel, as well as your binary symmetric channel with the help of mutual information. And what is mutual information? It is basically the information transferred from your source to the destination. Or in terms of random variable also, we have given that particular definition, that is I of x semicolon y will going to gives us the information about the information transferred from x to your random variable y. So now in this particular lecture, we will going to discuss about the error-free communication over the noisy channel and Shannon upper bound over your channel capacity. So error-free communication over a noisy channel. In our earlier lecture also, we have also discussed that in your digital communication system, we'll be basically having three ingredients, that is your transmitter, receiver, and to interconnect between your transmitter and receiver, we'll be having some physical medium channel. So the objective of any communication system is to transfer the maximum amount of information from source to the destination or your receiver. So the actual transformation of information from source to the destination is majorly affected by the channel conditions. And channel is the major source of your noise, or it is the place where noise will going to add it up to our signal, and it will basically going to distort and make it difficult for our receiver to detect it properly. So this is the generalized criteria. So the message from source X with entropy H of X can be encoded by an average of H of X digits per message. This we had already seen, that for our information source X, the entropy associated with it would have been given by your H of X, which gives us the information about the average number of digits per message symbol. So there is no possibility of error-free communication over a noisy channel when the messages are encoded with zero redundancy. Since we had already discussed that our signal or information must have to be transported through the channel, and if that channel is noisy, then obviously it will going to corrupt our information signal. So in that particular case, there will be no possibility for error-free communication over that noisy channel. Obviously, if our channel is noiseless, then we can say that the error-free communication might be possible. But in general cases where our channel would have been considered as your noisy, so in that particular case, your error-free communication is not possible, especially when the information signal would have been encoded with zero redundancy. About redundancy, we have already discussed that it is some extra amount of information or bits that would have been added, which is not actually the part of information, but somehow they would have been allowing us to understand the information properly. So Shannon has shows that it is possible to achieve the error-free transmission of information by adding aggregate redundancy. That is, if we will going to add up some extra bits to our information signal that would have been transported through the channel, then in that particular case, we can achieve this error-free communication over that noisy channel. So redundancy is nothing but your extra bit that we have already discussed that would have been added to the information to process the information at the receiver, and it basically allows us to detect it properly. So what do we mean by redundancy, and how we're going to add redundancy to any given information signal? So in this particular case, we are assuming that we'll be using some parity, and we are basically trying to transfer our information signal with the help of parity, whether it is even parity or odd parity. So the extra parity bit increases the average word length by 1, that is h of x plus 1. Since h of x is the average number of bits required for your information per message. And since we are adding this particular parity on per message basis, so in that particular case, the average word length would have been increased by your 1, that will be equal to h of x plus 1. So where the efficiency would have been given as that particular symbol neta, and that will be the ratio of average message bits divided by your complete code word length. That will be the summation of this average message plus we have used this one parity bit. So that will be equal to 1. So it will be the ratio of hx over hx plus 1. And redundancy would have been given as, which is nothing but it is the difference of 1 minus efficiency, that will be equal to 1 over h of x plus 1. So this is how we are going to calculate the redundancy. So now the classical theory is that whatever we have studied in our analog communication system, it basically suggests that for high quality reception for the signal, the received SNR should be maximized. That is, if at the receiving side we will going to receive high signal to noise ratio, then obviously the actual signal reception would have been possible without gone through much distortion. So here this SNR is nothing but it is the ratio of your signal power to the noise power, which would have been given as your SI over N0 of B, where this SI is nothing but it is your signal power and N0 B is nothing but it is your noise power. This N0 is your noise power spectral density and B is the bandwidth. So the product of noise power spectral density with your bandwidth will going to gives us your noise power. So this is simply the ratio of signal power to the noise power. So the error probability, whatever earlier discussions we have made about your error probability, so any type of error probability would have been of the type of e to the power minus k times of eb over n0. So whatever error probability discussions we have done so far, so if we are talking about any sort of modulation system such as your ASK, PSK, FSK, QPSK or whatever type of digital modulation schemes, we have found out that the error probability is of the form of e to the power minus k eb over n0. Whether we have studied in terms of your Q function or error function or complementary error function, it is more or less of this particular type. So obviously here we are assuming your asymptotic approximation, that is we are considering some extreme cases. So the signal power SI, obviously if we will going to incorporate that analogy into our digital communication system, we are going to find that signal power will be equal to EB times of RB, where this EB is the energy per bit and RB is the bit rate, that is number of bits transmitted per unit time. So how we can make this error probability will be equal to 0 so that we can say that we have achieved this error free communication. So in order to make the error probability to 0, we can do two things. What we can do is either we can make this your EB to infinity. So when we are talking about your error probability P, which is directly proportional to e to the power minus k times of EB over n0. So when this EB will tending towards your infinity, then your error probability will tending towards your 0. So this is the first thing that we can do. Or second thing, what we can do is reduce the RB to 0. So what here we actually wanted to say is we want to make this EB to infinity. So if it is not possible for us, then what purposefully we could do is we can increase your bit duration. So if bit duration will going to get increased, so the energy contained in your bit will obviously going to increase. And if energy per bit will going to increase, then definitely it will going to reduce out your error probability. So if bit duration will going to increase, so obviously the bit rate will going to reduce, just because they will be going to have this inverse relationship. That is TB is equal to 1 over RB and vice versa. So obviously if you're going to increase your bit duration, so your bit rate will going to reduce. So if we will going to make this bit rate will be equal to 0, so that will not going to serve our purpose since we are not at all transmitting any sort of information. So eventually both of these cases is not possible. So if this is not possible, it means that error free communication over the noisy channel is not possible. So is that the case? So Shannon basically suggested that it is possible to have error free communication if the average transmission rate and transmitted power both are finite. So Shannon basically suggested this particular idea. We have seen that the maximum information rate supported by your channel is termed as your channel capacity. In our last class also, while discussing this mutual information and channel capacity, we have discussed that. So channel capacity would have been given as maximum of P of x. Obviously, here we are basically trying to maximize this source probability. I of x semicolon y is basically going to give us the information about, it is basically the information transferring from x to y times of R of s, where R of s is nothing but it is basically signifying your symbol rate. So this is the maximum channel capacity. So here the important point is what Channel suggested, that how we will going to achieve this error-free communication over the noisy channel. So Shannon has suggested that the error-free communication is being possible if the average information rate R is made lower than the channel capacity C, which would have been given by this particular expression, which is the function of bandwidth of the channel and the SNR at the receiver. So what it basically suggested is, if for transmitting our information, if that information rate is make lesser than the maximum channel capacity, then we can achieve error-free communication over the noisy channel. And that channel capacity will be the function of your bandwidth as well as the SNR. So now we're going to discuss this Shannon channel capacity, that is how Shannon have described this channel capacity. So if the information rate R, that is made lesser than this capacity C, then there exists a coding technique such that the information can be transmitted over the channel with arbitrary small error probability. So obviously, again, here we are not at all saying that it is completely error free, but still with very small error probability, it is possible to achieve almost error free transmission. But if your information rate is greater than that theoretical channel capacity, then error free transmission is impossible. That is, we will going to have larger amount of errors in signal transmission. So C is the maximum possible error-free information transmission rate. Even in the noisy channel, there is no obstruction of the reliable transmission, but only a limitation of the rate at which transmission can take place. So obviously, if we will going to make this information rate lesser than your capacity, then we are in a state to avail or achieve this error-free communication, or you could say information transformation with limited error. But here the important point is, we have to limit the information rate, then only we are in a state to transport our information with complete reliability. So Shannon theorem does not tells us how to construct such a capacity approaching code, but it is only suggesting us that if we will going to limit the information rate, then we can achieve our reliable communication. So with the sampling rate, f of s is equal to 2 of b, where b is nothing but it is your bandwidth. So the Gaussian channel capacity would have been given as, we are assuming that your physical channel model would have been represented with this your Gaussian channel, which is basically used to model your wired communication channel. If you are assuming that, the channel capacity will be equal to fs times of I of xy, where this I of xy is nothing but it is the mutual information from source x to destination y. And this fs is nothing but it is your sampling rate or symbol rate, you can say. So that will be equal to b times of log base to 1 plus snr bits per second. So here this is your Shannon channel capacity. So Shannon has suggested that channel capacity will be equal to b log base to 1 plus snr bits per second. So here in this particular lecture, we will not going to into greater detail about the derivation of this particular thing, but idea should be clear that Shannon has suggested some rate limiting fundamentals to achieve this error free communication over the noisy channel, and that channel capacity would have been given by this your b times of log base to 1 plus snr, and the unit is your bits per second, that is maximum number of bits transmitted per unit time, where this b is the bandwidth. So SNR, we have already discussed that it is the ratio of signal power to the noise power, and it would have been given as your SI over N0B, where this SI is nothing but your signal power, and N0B is nothing but your noise power, B is the bandwidth, and N0 is the noise power spectral density. So for digital communication, signal bandwidth B is the channel bandwidth, sampling rate FS is the symbol rate, as we had already discussed that it is equal to your RS, that is symbols per second, number of symbols transmitted per unit time, and N0 is the power spectral density of the AWGN channel, since we are assuming your Gaussian channel. So now we're going to discuss a numerical problem based on your Shannon channel capacity formula. So channel has the SNR of 15. So if the channel bandwidth is reduced by half, determine the increase in the signal power required to maintain the same channel capacity. Here, one thing should be noted that since channel capacity C will be equal to B times of log base to 1 plus S by N. So, if we will going to reduce the bandwidth, then anyhow, we must have to increase the signal power to maintain the same channel capacity. If you will not going to increase your signal power, then obviously the channel capacity will going to get reduced since it is having the direct proportional relationship with your bandwidth. So channel capacity would have been given as your B times of log base to 1 plus SI over N0B, which is nothing but your SNR. What we basically did is we have modified our bandwidth, and here we have represented it as your B dash times of log base to 1 plus the modified signal power. Let us assume that SI bar upon N0 of B bar, where B bar is your modified bandwidth. So after putting the value of SNR, that is SNR is given to us 15, 15 plus 1, that turns out to be 16, and log base to 16, that will be equal to 4. So 4 times of B, that will be equal to the modified bandwidth given to us from your numerical problem is B dash will be equal to B by 2. So we have just put this value of B dash as your B by 2 times of log base to 1 plus SI bar over SI. So we just simply have multiplied by SI and divide by this SI, and we have made our expression like this. And for N0 times of B dash, whatever we have written is N0 times of, instead of B dash, we have put this B by 2. So now what we're going to get is, so this B and this B will going to get cancelled, and this 2 will get multiplied with this 4. So what we are left with is 8 is equal to log base 2 1 plus SI bar over SI, and this SI upon N0B, that would have been given to us 15, it will get multiplied with 2, so that turns out to be your 30. So 8 will be equal to log base to 1 plus 30 times of SI bar over SI. So when we're going to evaluate this particular thing, what we are left with is your, so 2 to the power 8, that turns out to be 256, that will be equal to 1 plus 30 times of SI bar over SI. So it means SI bar turns out to be 8.5 times of SI. So it means that we need to increase our signal power by 8.5 times in order to achieve the same channel capacity. Hopefully you guys have get the insight about your Shannon channel capacity. In case of any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll try to solve them out as soon as possible. So these are the references. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.